Okay, here that I prepared the some chemical equation that involving the splitting effects of two different ligand, which is the splitting effects of the H2O. Okay, H2O, which is it is the weak ligand. Okay, and compared to ethylene the amine ligand, which is ethylene the amine ligand is a strong fit ligand. So how it affected the current complex ion. Okay, so now, okay, when this the aqueous of hexa aqua nickel 2 plus, okay, is react to the ethylene the amine ligand. Okay, we can see that okay, before that, okay, we see the this color chart. Okay, so this is the nature of the ion, centrometer ion color. Okay, so we refer to our centrometer here is a nickel 2 plus. So for nickel 2 plus, okay, from this diagram, nickel 2 plus, nickel 2 plus is a green color. Okay, so nickel 2 plus is a green color. Okay, currently, okay, what is the color changes when it react with the another ligand, which is we added the ethylene diamine into the aqueous of hexa aqua nickel 2 plus. Okay, so refer to the this color wheel. Okay, basically nickel is a consists of a aqua, which is a weaker ligand. Okay, weak fit ligand, which is when weak fit ligand, it will produce the splitting the orbital smaller of splitting the orbital. Okay, so since it's produced the it's appeared the green color, so we can say that the aqua, okay, the presence of aqua, okay, will absorb the red color. Okay, the red color, which is a longer wavelength. Okay, longer wavelength, eh? Since it have a weak fit ligand. Okay, how about the present of ethylene diamine? Okay, when the present of ethylene diamine, which is a stronger fit ligand, so for sure that the electron, okay, will form the electron exciting, okay, excitation of electron will cause the greater energy difference, which also make the shorter wavelength. Okay, so it will produce the blue color, since that the present of En here, okay, the present of En here, okay, which is shorter wavelength. Okay, so the complementary color that we show here, that we appear here, is a blue color. So that's why for the product form, okay, for the new complex ion is a appeared as a blue color, okay, because of the stronger fit ligand present, okay, in the system. Okay, so now, okay, we take a look for the second equation. Okay, now currently the complex ion is a blue color, alright, in a blue light color. Okay, how about we react it with a ethylene diamine ligand. Okay, we use aqueous ethylene diamine. We put into the aqueous of ethylene diamine. Okay, aqua. Okay, tetra aqua ethylene diamine nickel 2 plus. Okay, so now is okay. So what color is appeared here is a purple. Okay. Okay, so the purple appeared. Okay, this shows that. Okay, this shows that, okay, the presence of ethylene diamine here, okay, cause the shorter wavelength. Okay, the presence of the strong fit ligand cause the energy difference become larger, okay, and the wavelength become shorter. So what is the complementary color, okay, of yellow here is a purple, okay, okay, light purple, okay, right. So this is the new one. Okay, this is the first Okay, first new complex. Okay, this is the second new complex. Okay, now. Okay, the third reaction. Okay, for the diaqua diethylene diamine. Okay, diaqua bisethylene diamine nickel 2+. Alright. Okay, when the presence of the aqueous of ethylene diamine here. Okay, ethylene diamine here. Okay, so what happened is, alright, so okay, we can say that the wavelength become shorter. Okay, the presence of the another stronger fit ligand, okay, it cause the shorter wavelength become shorter. So what is the color absorbed here is a green color. Okay, which is this green color is a complementary of the green color here is a between of a red and purple. Make the color is a violet. So this is the violet color, violet color. Okay, it's like magenta color. So this is the new colored form. So this is the new complex form, which is tris ethylene diamine, okay, nickel 2+ ion. Okay, so this is we call as a displacement of ligand. Okay, hope you will understand for this equation. All right.